All right, so this goes on the back here.
Have you ever wondered about the hat that says, "This is me, this is who I am," or the hat that people will always remember you for, or maybe a hat that will be passed down to your children and grandchildren? Sheila Monroe makes hats, weird, wonderful hats out of really funky materials. And today we're gonna find out what inspires her. Is this the perfect hat for me?
You know, I think it's definitely a candidate. Maybe you should, well, let's try this one on
okay.
you though. Yeah, let's
All
take
right.
a look. That can just slide on the back of your head there.
There we go.
Yeah, and this one sort of goes on like a hairpiece. Just gonna make sure it feels good on you there. And there we go.
There we go.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Huh? I don't know. It's hard to say which one I like better. Maybe I like this one better. Yeah, looks good.
By day, Sheila Monroe crunches numbers for an environmental sciences firm. By night, she's an artist and designer, creating unique hats, belts, and bags from a makeshift studio in her backyard. Her focus is on hats, eclectic homemade creations she couldn't find at the local mall.
Basically, not being able to find the perfect hat. I've always been a fan of very couture work. So when you look in magazines and you see these elaborately, you know, things that are covered every inch with lace and ruffles and leather and everything, it's always appealed to me. I use snake skin, I use ostrich, I use stingray, I use different types of fish leather, different grades of lamb and cow leather, fine satins and embroidered laces and things, velvets, things like that to name a few.
She's inspired by big city media, TV, magazines, but her small town friends influence her work the most.
When you start to show your work, you start to meet more people that are interested in the same types of things. And, you know, we all inspire each other. And then, of course, there's, you know, TV and magazines and everything. But I'd have to say that some of my friends and fellow artists are the most inspiring people to me. Who buys them? They're, well, performers, belly dancers, also just people that really enjoy and love fashion. You know, sometimes it's been bikers. Sometimes it's been somebody that, you know, has an elaborate hat and they just walk up in a pair of jeans and a shirt and they want, you know, that they like the hat. So, I mean, it's definitely a different kind of style. However, I think it could be for everyone, depending on how much you like to, you know, dress up, I guess.
Monroe says even if you're not a hat person, there's a perfect lid for everyone.
The perfect hat. Well, I think that attention to detail is really important and just something that's very well made. But I think that the colors have to flow nicely and it has to be finished very nice. And I like stones too, like moonstones and labradorite. I often set those in hats, fossils. So you know, this is sort of a style that is inspired from other, you know, styles from the 30s and things, but it was my perfect hat. It was the 30s, but then adding, you know, leather and stones and things that you didn't really see people doing at that stage.
You can check out Monroe's line of hats on the internet. Her company's called Dropping Form Designs. She'll even give you a hand like she did for me in picking out a hat that could be your new signature look. For Shaw TV, I'm Shelley Joyce.